Nobody plays guitar like this guy.
Are you ready to learn how to put wow factor into Linda Ronstadt's version of You're No Good? Aw, oh, come on into the studio. You're going to love this one. You know which one it is. It's got that real famous little riff in there that goes like this. Now you know. Come on into the studio. I'll show you how to play it. Okay, let me show you the intro, and then I'm going to show you... Actually, let me show you the chords that we're going to play first, and then I'll show you the intro. You got an A minor, because this is a very simple song, and there's... for beginners, it's pretty easy even for beginners. If you're just an intermediate player, it's going to be real simple for you, because there's only a couple of chords in it. You got your A minor, you've got a D, you've got an E, an F. I said just a few chords, didn't I? But... they're easy chords. G, C, okay? Now you're also gonna play a C chord. By the way, now make sure that you understand we've got a capo on the first fret. So everything that I'm saying is raising up on the fret board one fret up, okay? So make sure your capo's on the first fret. When we play a C chord, I want you to play a C chord like an F. So you got F, that'd be a G, A, B, C is on the 8th fret, okay? I'm sorry, the 9th fret. And if you can, if you're a beginner player, you may not be able to do this, and that's okay. But you're going to use this when they have that lead in the very middle of the song, okay? If you can play it, play that C chord on the 9th fret. Like you're playing an F chord. And I'll have diagrams on there for you. I just wanted to tell you what chords we're playing. Now let me show you how that intro starts off. Okay, the intro, all we're gonna do is do an A minor and a D. Now watch that strumming that I'm doing on there, okay? If you're an intermediate player, if you're a beginner player, you can keep strumming like that. Notice one thing that I want to share with you. When I'm strumming, I'm trying to keep my strumming very, very smooth and syncopated. And what I'm doing is I'm just taking my fingers off the frets to give it a little bit different sound, or maybe muting, or a little bit different stroke, but for the most part, my strumming is going to be very, if you watch my wrist, okay, very smooth strumming like that. So if you can play, if you're an intermediate player, here's what you want to do. Okay, take your fingers when you're playing that A chord, that A minor, lift them up off of the fretboard and put it back. So you got, the other thing you want to do is mute those chords. That makes it really sound cool. You hit that A minor, and then I'm muting that A minor. Then I go to my D, mute again. There's another little piece of wow factor that you can put in here and do a little bass riff with that fifth string. And all I'm doing, I'm taking my pinky and I'm picking up the third fret of the fifth string. Then I get my index finger, second fret of the fifth string, and then open five. One other thing I want to share with you, when you do that D, another wow factor that you can put in is go like this. Like that, okay? You can do that part of the time, and you can do that little bass riff. If you want to do these double notes, double stop, all you want to do there, you've got your D chord formed, and I'm just playing the second and third strings of that D. So you got 3 on 2, 2 on 3, and then, and right there, that double stop, you've got an index finger, first fret on the second string, middle finger, second fret on the third string. And then open. Open two, open three, back to your A minor. I'm mixing those up a few times. When you're playing by yourself, it just makes it sound a little bit better, okay? So that's all you're doing on your intro is just those chords, that A minor and D, and then Linda Ronstadt, whoever's singing for you, starts singing the verses, A minor and D. Then he goes to an F. So all you're doing there, F to a G, and then a C. And then there's a walk down. If you're if you can play a little walk down, if you can put this wow factor into it, and all you're doing is walking down on the third fret of the fifth string, second fret of the fifth string, first fret of the fifth string, A minor. All you're doing, you got that F, G to a C, A minor, D, and an E. Okay, that's where he goes into that A minor. Okay, you play that, then he goes into another verse. After that second verse, that cool little riff comes in there, and I'm going to show you how to play it, and then I'm going to put a tab up there for you, but I want you to listen to it because there's a trick to playing this. Trick technique. Okay? And then here's what the technique is. And here I'm going to put the tab on the screen for you. If you'll notice, there's those three notes on there. I've got the 6 on 4, 6 on 3, and 4 on 2. Okay? You're not strumming that right now. I'm just showing you it to play this riff. It's much easier if you'll form your fingers in that pattern right there. 6, 6, 4. Okay, and the reason is, look at that tab that I have up there. You're playing that 6 on 4. And then you go, so you're playing your 4th fret and your 4th string, 2nd string. And then you go 4 string, 3 string. I'm sorry. 4 string, 2nd string, 4, 3, and then you change. Look at that diagram that I have on the screen. Okay, you're hitting those three strings. And I'm doing that with an upstroke. When I hit those three strings, I'm hitting an upstroke. Okay, now look at that next finger pattern, right? You've got, what is that? That should be... It's the 4th fret. I'm confusing you. I'm sorry, because I'm thinking, how do I tell you the best, because I've got that fret up there. You're actually on the 4th fret, okay, on your fretboard, but because of that capo, it's actually 3. But you got... I'm gonna write down the fret that you're on. You're actually on the 4th fret on this one. 4th fret on 4, 6th fret on 3, and 5th fret on the 2nd string. Now, notice that next pattern, right? Those three strings, that's where I want you to put the formation of your fingers. And you're playing it the same way. but now it's just a different finger formation. And when you hit that chord, you're coming up. Now, expect that to take a little bit of time trying to get your fingers and your mind coordinated on what you're doing there. It did me. So it may take you a little time getting your fingers coordinated like that, but I think if you'll put those formations down before you start playing that riff, it'll be a lot easier for you. So here's what else we're doing. We're doing that. He does that four times. Right now, a bass comes in. That dun, da, dun, da, da, do, 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 do. Okay, now here you go on the rest of your lick. Goes, because you're playing a single guitar, you're not going to be able to play all those little lead riffs in there and make it sound right. So I'm going to make it sound full for you by playing chords, and all we're going to do is pick some notes in there. So what we're going to use, the chords, we're going to do an F. And slide up to a G. There's your F chord. Slide up to a G with that same F chord formation. And then all the way up to the ninth fret to play a C chord. All right, because we got the capo on there. So you got F, G, a C. And all I'm doing on that, now I know that's not anything that he's playing, but I'm telling you, if you play this by yourself and you try and throw that in on a lead riff, the intent of the song comes through and the people like it. So here's what your riff is all the way through there. Then I'm going to slide down on that sixth string, and I'm going to go like this. Okay, and it sounds pretty close there. So you got to play it one more time. Okay, so all I'm doing, I'm playing an A chord or an A minor. I'm taking my fingers off the fretboard, putting them back on, and then when I go to the D, I just slide down to the first fret and back up to the second, and then I do the same thing with an E chord. So because of the capo, I'm going up to the fifth fret like that, and when I'm doing that, I'm coming up on the first and second string, and then I do a quick slide on that third string on the fourth fret, fifth fret on the regular fretboard, fourth fret down to three and two on the fourth string. So it's like this. Repeat that on that E chord. For me, the easiest thing there is I'm sliding down from, five down to two, and then two again on the fourth string. So, hit that fourth string, the second fret on that fourth string, I'm changing fingers and using my middle finger. It's easier for me that way. You may not find it like that, but it's easier for me to do it that way. So it goes, whoops. That's it through the whole song. Those are the only chords. Man, that took a lot to explain that to you. I hope you didn't get bored with me. Great song to play, especially that little lead riff in there. Pick that out. People are going to love it. Hey, keep watching, keep practicing, keep playing the guitar. And remember this, stay close to the Lord. I'll see you in the next video.
Subscribe now.